Good evening, ladies and gents. Welcome back. And if you haven't made it here, welcome to the Bendigo Stadium NBL 1 action. It is the men, the Bendigo Braves men versus the Centre of Excellence. I'm Brian Coughlin, and this is Adam Allerton beside me.
Well, thanks, Brian. In the first game, you've pulled the cord and nearly pulled my head off. Now, yelling into the microphone, you're nearly blowing the cans off my ears.
Sorry about that, mate. This is going to be a good game, I think.
I think, speaking of blowing the cans off the ears, I think the spectators will be loud. There's a good crowd in. They came in early for the women's game. They saw a good game. Good to see the women after the game standing, sitting down and actually signing a lot of autographs and getting plenty of advice. Now, yeah, this is a good game because it's not the strongest Braves side of all side time, but they went down to Melbourne Tigers and MSAC last Sunday and got a W.
They certainly did, and they're about to be introduced, so we'll do that for you as well. As the cheerleaders make their way out here in Bendigo, we love our cheerleaders. First time at the stadium for the Braves. Junior squad members are coming out with the guys, which is a terrific little gesture. I think it's a good initiative by basketball, and maybe it'll be copied around the place, Adam, you would think, or not?
Yeah, I think it's the way to go. Bendigo Braves have even got a junior in Dyson Daniels on their list, so I think that's a great experience for him, I think. But the way they incorporate the senior and junior programs at Bendigo's first class.
Absolutely.
It's one club, one family.
Number two is Matt Bartlett for the Bendigo Braves. Number three is the youngster who played well last year, Jake Lloyd. He's had a haircut too.
You're not a fan of the man bun,
no,
are you, Brian?
He's got rid of the man bun. Number five is Tanner Rayner. Number 10 is a youngster by the name of Jordan Mangan. Number 11, this boy is 15 years old. His old man was a superstar. His name, actually, he's not number 11. I'll take that back. This is Jake Cowling. Jake Cowling goes all right too. Matt Johnston is number 20.
No, Dyson Daniels is listed as number 11.
He is, yeah. As they make their way around now, Dan Hansen makes his way out. And I reckon they leave the big fellas to last. Here he is, making his way out. Is the new recruit, Deontay Burton. I reckon we're going to see some good stuff from him too. This is Dyson Daniels, 15 years of age. He wouldn't be much older than the kid he's walking with. Here's one of the co-captains, long-time player with the Braves. Over 350 games, Chris Hogan.
How would you go with a family member coaching you?
I think he'd struggle. His brother is the new coach. And co-captain of the Braves this year, Matt Andronicus. Also been with the system for a couple of years now. Loves a tattoo. But how's this guy? Crowd favourite. Loved his dunks last year. I think we're going to have a dunk city this year with the one and only Ray Turner.
Yeah, he does know how to go upstairs, Ray. Good to see JC back in the coaching ranks
Justin
too.
Cass is over there as well, as you said, which is good. David Hogan is the new coach of the Braves. And the coach for the Centre of Excellence is Adam Corpon. We're going to get into the National Anthem, which, of course, is a very big part of the Bendigo Stadium every time we have a Braves game. So let's enjoy. As the windows break here at the stadium, what a voice. Fantastic. I'll get a name for you, but I don't know it. Okay, we are just minutes away from a start here. Round two, the Bendigo Braves taking on the Centre of Excellence in what's going to be, we both think, a ripping match, Adam Ellerton.
Yeah, it's similar to the women. It's where they're all underage players. These are 16, 17, 18-year-olds. So it's boys against men, but they're very talented boys. And from what we saw from the women's, is the kind of discipline that they play with, we're going to see a very good game of basketball.
Yeah, certainly. And again, a win for the Braves last week. The Centre of Excellence will be looking to get on the list.
Yeah, just there's one other game tonight, which is Hobart v Nutterwadding. We'll keep you updated with that down in beautiful Tasmania. Yeah, as I said before, the coaches of the Nutterwadding, the coaches of Centre of Excellence, they're there to develop players. They're not there for wins and losses, but wins and losses are a bonus. But they're here to compete, and they're here to compete hard. That's why they're in this league.
Exactly right.
They're not. Bendigo, huge weekend tonight, Centre of Excellence, and then the arch enemy Ballarat tonight. First home game of the season, they'll want to start off well, and nothing's taken for granted, you know. I'm really looking forward to this game. It's Braves, similar list to last year, but a few faces. Deontay Burton's come in. You and I don't know much about him.
We know he's a superstar. He's got big raps on him. We know that.
Well, call me cynical, Brian, but every American import that comes out seems to have huge raps on them. Not, it's all about delivering. He's just jumped off a plane and arrived in the country. He doesn't know the systems of the team. You can't judge him on the first couple of games, but we'll see what he brings. He's a guard size, so hopefully he's a good shooting guard, which is what Bendigo needs. Because they've certainly got the tall timber, Bendigo. There's no problem with that. It's all about helping Ray Turner with some scoring.
Yeah, that's for sure. You can see the boys as they do their thing. I'd suggest a couple of Sudanese boys as well. It's just these kids can play. Don't worry about that. I'm excited just to see what they can do.
And there's a few boys of Sudanese background that are playing in the NBA,
yes,
and in the NBL. So a very exciting time for Australian basketball. Men, the men have got a World Cup this year as well. Very strong lineup for men's basketball. Our NBA stars will be playing in that. The Australian Boomers have got two games against the United States of America at Marvel Stadium, so that's going to be huge. Unfortunately for basketball fans, LeBron James not coming out for that. But yeah, look, a very, very exciting year for men's basketball.
There you go. That's what's happening around the place, and certainly if you can share the NBL One action, which we're supplying through SuperU live streaming right around Australia and the world, make sure you do, because we're going to see a ripping game coming your way as we get set for what's going to be huge. And straight away, Ray Turner and Deontay Burton seem to get on well, and that's a worry for opposition teams, because Ray can dunk, and they tell me Deontay is just the same.
Well, he's good luck competing with Big Ray, because he is a dunking machine. Last week, the Centre of Excellence are competitive against Kilsyth. They've gone down by five there, so that's not a bad result. I'll just double check that, of course, because the women have played three games, so I presume the men have played three games as well.
You would think so, yeah.
So I'll just look up those stats. Yeah, they lost by five against Kilsyth. Lost by 11 against Ringwood, which is one of the teams that we're not familiar with. So we're really looking forward to seeing what Ringwood can produce. So, and I'll just get the results of their third game. They've won a game, Brian. They beat Dandenong. They've always been strong in men's basketball. So these kids can play, obviously.
They can certainly play, and unlike years gone past, as we know, they certainly were thrown to the wolves a little bit, but these days, I mean, they've got the height. You can probably see that on our SuperU cameras,
yeah.
The fact that the boys are all fairly tall.
Yeah, they just need to fill out a little bit. Ray Turner's probably going to push them about inside, but that's just part of the experience. And all part of the development so these guys can have NBL 1 and NBL careers and maybe even further.
Check your starting five any minute as we get closer to game time, thanks to the Bendigo Copy Centre.
Sorry, Brian, I was busy looking up the results for Bendigo. It's Chris Hogan, Matt Andronicus, Ray Turner. Daniels gets a start.
Well, that's just great news. Dyson Daniels, 15-year-old. He is the son of the legendary Ricky Daniels, which Ricky's actually not too far away.
Yeah, he'd be
here. He's sitting over here, so we might have to catch up with Rick.
And Deontay Burton in his first game starts. For the Centre of Excellence, you got Bowen Dukas, Lee Goodrick and Coonan.
Okay, we've got some interesting names for the Centre of Excellence. I wonder if
we really need to have a pre-season thing and learn the pronunciations of the names.
46 for the Centre of Excellence is Banjo Talbot. Let's see how Banjo goes a little bit later as he makes his way into the court. Here we go, Bendigo versus the Centre of Excellence.
You'll have it on a string, Brian.
We will. Oh, you won't be fiddling around anywhere. Deontay Burton. Let's have a look at the young star. He's not that young,
actually. Keep watching, folks. It gets better.
Look at it. Oh, Ray. No. Oh, he got there anyway. Ray Turner got there anyway.
Oh.
Well, what a start. First 30 seconds. Don't you love it? Good points, though. Centre of excellence through Isaiah Lee.
This continues up for another 39 minutes. Give me some of this.
Young boy Daniels. Hogan. Chris Hogan goes for three, doesn't get there. Tried to come back. Was Burton, but it'll be a centre of excellence ball. Wow, what a first 30 seconds.
Yeah, Ray getting the dunk and getting a friendly roll, and then from outside, just the centre of excellence just droning one. That's good basketball, mate.
Lee gives it across from his teammate, gets it back, and first points, or second points, I should say, for him. Kyle Bowen was nice in there with a pass for the centre of excellence. He's the youngster, Daniels. Gives it to Ray. There's about 22 years between those two. Andronicus, good strength around the ring. Goes again. Pops it in. A little half dunk that everyone's happy about at the stadium here in Bendigo.
Yeah, that's what we call a jam, mate. Not the full dunk. But
not quite. Here we go behind this two. Just off the ring. They'll get it back, though, the centre of excellence through the youngster in Coonan. On your super use screen, he gets it back, Coonan. Very athletic, bends one, should make an easy basket, doesn't. Needed it, wanted it, didn't get it. Ray Turner.
Oh, look at Ray go to
push
work.
Push to the line, how about the throw around the corner?
Oh, sloppy.
It was cute, it was there, but Andronicus was probably too cute.
I'm going to get off topic, but you can see Hogan, the coach, in the background. What in the hell is he wearing?
We're not sure. It's his style. It's what he wants to do. He looks good, Chris.
David.
Very stylish.
Looks like
push.
He's come from a dinner date.
Push. And again, he's a big fella. Can he push it? He's got a bit of muscle in there. It was hard work for Goodrick. This might be easier. And here's nice work, Alex Dukas.
Looks like they don't mind a shot from outside. Dukas has put one in the hole. Lee's dropped a couple. Big Andronicus is just going to get another easy
basket. They still trail by two. The centre of excellence in front by two.
But, really exciting, free-flowing game of basketball. Two different ways of going about it. Centre of excellence shooting it.
Good Rick. Got a push in there. Didn't get the basket. We'll grab the foul early.
Yeah. Best way, get Ray Turner into foul trouble. But, so centre of excellence happy to shoot the ball from outside. Bendigo happy to take it inside. Two contrasting ways of going about the job, but both of them working.
Early stages, what a game we've got here at the Bendigo Stadium. It's only round two. Wait till we get to the later rounds. Wow. Basketball at a very high standard.
I've only got one criticism of the centre of excellence. I'd love to see the boys with the names on the back of their shirts.
Yeah, that would help. Help me anyway.
No, that wasn't... I just want the fans to get some recognition and going, who's number four?
That's true.
You're calling him, but I would like Goodrick to go, hey, everyone knows his name, rather than going number four. That's country footy stuff.
Which is Hunter Goodrick, by the way.
Another interesting first name. He's got plenty of them.
Daniels getting a little coverage from Lee.
He's 189 centimetres. Doesn't look that tall. He's only going to get taller. That's what's frightening.
Dan Hansen the recruit, Burton, Deontay Burton.
Let's see what skills he's got.
Pushes all the way. Knew what he wanted to do to Hogan, to Hanson. We're behind this for three. Doesn't get there. Rebound by Kunin. As they push up, good D by the Braves. We're all over this at the moment here at the Bendigo Stadium. Bowen, he's still got it. Needed to offload it, did. Good Rick. Gives it back to his teammate in Lee. Doesn't get there. A couple of Braves boys say they fought over it. It was not the worst thing. Did a pace is good, Turner. Here's Burton for three. Doesn't get there. Off hands. And it will be the Braves sideball. Oh, sorry, Centre of Excellence sideball, I know.
Yeah, I didn't think the Braves were ever going to win that. Yeah, Deontay just lighting it up early. I'm not keen on that. Just chuck it around to your teammates. But you got to do a heat test every now and then, don't you?
You certainly do. Game is quick. Don't you worry about that. Nice push to the line by Bowen. Gives it back to a teammate. He's missed too. And the youngster in Tattersall. Hogan, been there a few times off the ring. Can he get it again? He can't. Nice work. Been very busy in there. Alex Dukas gives it to Goodrick. Still got it. We're right behind it with Bowen. No. Good hands. Was he outside the court? Ref says, shut up. Get on with it. I'll ref. From the corner again. This time, after a couple of shots, Hunter Goodrick says, give me a couple of points.
Yeah, he's up to eight now, I think. And there's a lot of boys on this team that have got some very good outside shots.
So, they trail by seven, the Braves. You'd think they were in front the way the pace they've played, but they just haven't scored. Great defence by the Centre of Excellence. This may help from Hogan. No. Off hands, Hanson. Youngster was too tall for him in Dukas. Centre of Excellence. I like the way they're going about this. Good pressure. Back to Goodrick. He likes some points. Doesn't get it. Ray Turner's been busy in defence. Not normally his position, Adam.
Oh, he's the number one rebounder in the comp. So I'd love to disagree with you there.
Hogan, here goes Burton. He looked good. Didn't get there. Rusty might be the word we're looking for. So they set up again. Hectic 5 minutes, first term, round two, NBL 1 action here at the Bendigo Stadium. Easy basket, or should be and is, for Isaiah Lee. Timeout call.
Yeah, beautiful basket. He did the pump fake and then committed his man to the defence and then drove it inside.
So 5 minutes gone, a little over. How about that?
I like what Bowen's doing in defence for the Centre of Excellence. He's playing physical basketball. He's pushing Ray out of the key. He's getting Ray out of the dangerous stuff area. So that's a good scout. Goodrick's got 8 points. I think he's been on fire. Lee's got five. They're just shooting the ball really, really well. They're impressive, aren't they?
They are. Very good.
So they do have an outside-inside game. They are prepared to take it to the hoop. Bendigo, on the other hand, all their points are coming from inside, which is what you're going to expect from them this season. Burton's first couple of minutes has just missed a few. Andronicus has been good with four. Turner two. That's where you think the majority of their points are going to come from. Like I said, Bendigo are not going to... Hanson can shoot a three ball, so can Hogan, but they just don't have that point-scoring guard that's going to do it. It's going to have to be the big boys that get the majority of the points.
Yeah, certainly. Trailing by nine, not exactly panic station, you wouldn't think so, for the new coach David Hogan and his assistants.
No, I wouldn't think so. It's just finding a way to get some offense going. And you've got to give Centre of Excellence credit. They're shooting the ball bloody well.
Right in front of us here. Nice pressure. Chris Hogan, nice work. Jake Lloyd's on the court for the Braves. Who's going to get some hands on it? He's been good. Young fella drags the foul. You're not happy about that, Kyle Bowen.
There's just no need for that foul. It's just he's not going to score points from that. It's just all you're doing is racking up a cheap one. And the refs love paying it. They just love it. You reach in, they just they call it every time.
So action's right in front of us, the Super U commentary box here at the Bendigo Stadium. Thanks to the Bendigo Copy Centre and also Pav Plumbing. Lee's been busy early. Isaiah Lee gives it to Dukas. He's been busy too.
Oh,
refs
nice
him
step.
Away, but he did well. More points for the centre of excellence. 11 the lead.
Went with the right hand. He could probably shoot that with the left. It's an easier shot, but made it with the right.
Bartlett on the court for the youngster in Daniels, Dyson Daniels.
See how they close Ray off there.
Hands weren't great there from Jake Lloyd. Didn't get it.
Rejection.
Got a nice rebound. Bartlett will take off down the court. What's he got on offer? Hansen does it. Braves crowd says better, much better.
Centre of excellence defending Turner really well. They get the weak side defender across to help, which means there's someone free.
Dukas, here he goes again. Doesn't get there. Geez, they'd be a long way in front if they'd shot everything. The centre of excellence, Lloyd, minus the ponytail. Bartlett, young boy, was at Shepparton for a long time. Brings it across. Here's Lloyd again. Faked.
Yeah, no one was buying it.
Over the top. Wasn't the greatest way to do it. Defensively, very poor. And the timeout's been called by the coach straight away. He will not be happy with that defensive action.
A kind statistician will say that's an assist. A mean one will say that was a missed shot.
So 7 points still lead for the centre of excellence. And the coach has just been reminding the boys that you can't lapse for any side.
No, their offence is pretty good, and the shots they've missed have generally rimmed out. So they're scoring at will. Braves finding it a bit more difficult. 3 minutes to go. Neither side really in any foul trouble, which probably means that they're not taking it inside as much as they should. Interesting game. I really don't know what to make of it. Centre of excellence have been great. Bendigo, they're only just going.
Yeah, they are, that's for sure.
But Goodrick with 8 points, Lee 7. They're the ones that are doing the damage. Just on the percentages, the shooting percentages, like you said, they're pretty low. Centre of excellence at 37 and Bendigo at 30. 30's not going to win you any game.
That's exactly right. Yeah, spot on.
I don't care what you say. And Bendigo 0 from 6 from outside, whereas centre of excellence are made 3 from 8. So a big 3 minutes. And then some.
So, here we go. Live action. Back here with Lee. Try to get a tipple on it.
Just a beautiful little floater.
Burton, but Lee just too good on that occasion. A lead by 9.
Yeah, just a little finger roll. He's a player, Lee. What's he got? 9 points. He's sensational.
Bartlett has a go for 3. Looks all right. Doesn't get there. Who's there to help him out? No one. Lee was a little tap. Are you happy in footy for that pass on? Oh, look at that. Nice work. But travel is the call. But I tell you what, regardless of the travel, that was real nice teamwork from the Centre of Excellence boys.
Yeah. You got to hustle in basketball. You want to do that. They were unlucky. Really good block by Hogan there, the cause of the travel. But, yeah, good hustle. They're not here for a loss.
Matt Andronicus back on the court for Ray Turner. Braves. Uses his muscle. Bartlett, been steady. Hansen, been a good starter for the Braves for a long time now. Hogan gives it back. Bartlett's quick in there to point guard. Back to Hansen. We're behind it. Doesn't get there. All hands with the excellence, centre of excellence, boys. Tried to steal it, Bartlett, but grab a foul for it instead.
Tough being a point guard on this side as he comes off and Dyson Daniels comes back into the game. And no, he doesn't. It's Hogan that's going off. His best avenue is the pass that's inside, which is a more risky pass. He just doesn't have an outside shooter to pass the ball to. So he's trying to create himself as well as get it to a man that's open. Not easy.
No, it's not. He's been good though, Isaiah Lee. Gives it to a mate. It's been all right too, Josh Coonan. Lee's got it back. In close. This boy's got some height. It's the boy we spoke about before. Banjo Talbot's on the court. Here's Jake Lloyd for three. Needed it. Andronikis has popped 0 points in, but will pick up a foul.
Yeah, it's that height inside. Dyson Daniels has got some wheels, good wheels on him. He moved down the floor real quick. So he will be a tall boy, but he's going to play a different position to his old man who was a centre. But he'll be more of a forward, I'd say. Time will tell. Not his best part of his game, Matt Andronikis.
No, that's not good.
No, centres generally aren't great free throw shooters.
Lee was good. Gives it across to the left hand. Another left hander. Nice work by Daniels in there. Lefty was Tattersall. Daniels, poise of a 15-year-old. Let's see how he goes. Going to try and have to push to the basket. Didn't get there. Drags the foul. Big banjo, Talbot.
To be 15, 16 and playing, running the floor in men's basketball is quite an achievement. And then take it to the rack.
With a boy, it's probably about 6'5", 6'6".
Yeah, he's 189, so that's probably 6'4". He's only going to get taller.
Yeah, boy, he played on then, drew the foul. There's a large type of lad as well in front of your screen there, number 46, Banjo Talbot.
Yeah, but what he does have is he has quick hands and quick feet, Dyson.
Good work. Get some points. They trail by 8, the Braves. First quarter. Feels like it's gone for a while. Trying to go all the way, the Sudanese lad. Gee, he's talented. On this occasion, he misses out Josh Coonan. Play from Dyson Daniels.
Yeah, we've got a horns up play here. Horns down play.
Andronikis. Chris Hogan always likes to fire. That's not Hogan, Brian. He looks a little bit like him. It's Jake Lloyd without the ponytail. Andronikis. Good block for him. Knew what he wanted to do. Bartlett. Time's down to 4. You can see that on your SuperU clock. Andronikis tried to tip it in. The defence has been terrific. Really has. They've really matched it big time with the Braves. And they haven't panicked the centre of excellence, especially this bloke, Lee, in front of us.
Lee is a point scorer.
Tries to go all the way. Doesn't get it there. Bit cute, bit smart. Here's Lloyd. There's a couple in front of him. Left to back off. They went behind him too with the pressure. I like that. Daniels. Bartlett will tell Daniels to get out of the way, which he does. Tried to go all the way. Still there. Bartlett brings it back. We're looking at the clock and everyone's counting in the crowd. Daniels has got to go for 3 and gets it! Dyson Daniels. Bloody 15. He pops it in.
He's 16 now, Brian.
All
but
right,
anyway,
just run with me on that. He's 15 and 365 days.
He's 16, but yeah, no time on the clock. Just drains one from downtown. Thank you. And didn't even celebrate.
Didn't worry about it. There's more to come from that boy. Here we go, right behind it. This one doesn't get there. It was Will Tattersall. They fought back, the Braves. They still trail by 5, quarter time for the Bendigo Copy Centre.
You made some really good points in that, boy, Brian. I think about Lee, who's got 9. His dribble penetration's good. He starts on the outside, he takes it inside. He tried a little floater that didn't go, but the finger roll did. He was fantastic. They got some shooters. They got some talent from outside. Goodrick's had 8. They've kind of been overshadowed by how good Lee's been. Andronikis and Daniels have been the scorers for Bendigo. They look like they're going to give some points. Bit quiet for Ray Turner. But as you said, really good defense. You keep the Braves to 14 points a quarter, you're not going to lose.
That's it.
You score 19 yourself. It's not a heck of a lot, but it'll do the job if you keep playing that defense. Coaches prefer good defense to a good offense. No, I've never seen a coach that's gone, oh, gee, let's play a nice high-scoring game here today. The fans love it, but coaches don't.
No, they don't, thanks to City Copy Centre.
Down in Hobart, it's not a wadding in the second period, halfway through the second period, 32-20 against Hobart. So that's
games.
It's the only other game going on at the moment. So I'll just look at some team stats. The shooting's not up to scratch. It's early days in the season. But Bendigo have produced a couple of blocks, which they're pretty happy about. But the scores are fairly even. There's not a lot in it, stats-wise. The difference is the scoreboard, and the centre of excellence are just playing better basketball.
That's it. Exactly right. Exactly right. And I think that's the key, isn't it?
Yeah, they've come out here with belief, and they're 1-2. They've certainly got the size. They don't have the physicality of Andronicus and Turner physically, but height-wise, they're generally a taller team than Bendigo. But they're all tall, but they can all shoot from outside. And then if they want to actually drive it to the hoop, they've got the height to put the ball up.
Foul action for both sides, pretty good. Talbot's the only one that's got a problem. He's got two for the centre of excellence, but not much else to write home about. Let's start the second quarter for the City Copy Centre in Queen Street, Bendigo. Good hands, Dukas. He was great. Gives it back to a teammate. Doesn't quite do it. Was Bowen. Turner. Feel like they're still in second gear. Dyson from Turner. Daniels, that is. And Ray Turner says, give me some points to start us off.
Yeah, nice little give to Ray. Dyson didn't like the shot. Gave it back to Ray. Ray put it in. Playing a good game, Daniels.
Here we go again. Gee, they don't muck around, I tell you. The centre of excellence. Hunter Goodrick couldn't get it, though.
Yeah, they're more... We saw the women work the clock. These guys, if they see a shot, they've got the licence to go. And for the most part, they're making a few of them. Burton. Oh, beautiful.
Oh, and here we go. Ray Turner.
Beautiful little alley-oop by Burton.
Big pass was on. And nice work. Everyone forgot and just looked at the dunk. And Will Tattersall said, I better score.
Yeah, Burton just said, chucked it up and gone, go get it, Ray. And Ray went and got it and chucked it down.
You'll see some action this year, particularly on the Bendigo Braves court from those two. And we did promise that. Burton pushes his opponent out of the way. No one there to get it. Ray Turner had three to beat, couldn't do it. And they go again. Centre of excellence. Goodrick to Lee. It's not Lee, sorry. Back to Dukas. This is Goodrick. Tried to push all the way. Will take the foul. Hans is not happy. Refs don't change their mind very often.
Hogan's not happy either, but that's the David, that is, I should say, which one? The coach of the Bendigo Braves. Burton's a bit trigger happy for me. I'd like to see him pass it around, and then if you've got a really good look or you've got it through sets of hands, then shoot the ball. But just seemed a bit early in the clock for me, but I'm not the coach.
Matt Johnston on for the Bendigo Braves, joined by teammate there. It's just made his way off for Hanson, and also Jake Lloyd take a break.
Got a really nice stroke, Goodrick. There's not much that can go wrong with it.
Jake Cowling's the other one. A couple of Jakes. A Jake replaces a Jake. Daniels at the age of 16.
Yep, 16. He's aged in about a quarter.
He has. Was 15 last quarter. Here is Daniels. Oh. Nice blind turn. Oh, he gives it to Turner. Turner should be able to pop it in. Well done, Daniels. But equally well done from the centre of excellence was Dennis. They just look organised. Here they go for three. Sits up, doesn't get there. Off hands. Daniels just seems to know where the ball is.
Yeah, I'm less worried about my point guard issue all the time because Daniels is 16. He fakes. He is prepared to shoot the ball, but he does like the assist. He can run the floor. Burton's running it on this play, but he did everything he could last play, Daniels, to get the score. They just didn't put it in. So here we go. He's going to work now.
He is. Tried to get around. Just gave it up. That's a bit of inexperience too. Yeah. Teammates have still got to help him out. Let's not just blame the kid.
No, he's caught off balance on the wrong foot.
Good Rick. He should make it all the way. Oh. Tried to be a bit cute there. Coach won't be happy with that.
Yeah, went the reverse. Blew by Daniels, but then just didn't put it in. Burton or the...
Cowling. He'll drag the foul, Cowling, and he'll take the foul as well.
That's what I want to see from Burton. Okay, shooting rubbish at the minute. I'll give him that. But the assists he's laid off have been fantastic. Just go out and do that. Get a good walk and do that. Just play the team game for the time being. Doing a good job. Just more of that. It's 20-23 all of a sudden. I don't know how. I'll have a look at the score in this quarter. There's not much in it.
Oh. Misses that, so that would have been nice. They trial by three. Centre of excellence been really good. Can they keep up this pace? Only time will tell. Kunin gave it to Bowen. He's been good, Bowen. Over to the corner, we're looking at Goodrick. He does it nicely, Hunter Goodrick.
I did say he had a nice stroke, Brian, and there's not much that can go wrong with it. And he's just very methodical, very mechanical. It's a beautiful stroke. He's going to make more than he'll miss.
We're going to have a good night at the Centre of Excellence, and we know they've won one, as you mentioned before.
And against Dandenong, against quality opposition, Daniel Striven, that ain't going to work. Ray's got 2 seconds.
Wants to get it going quickly. Doesn't get there. Might get it. No, doesn't get another chance. And Dukas cleans up.
Oh, yeah, mismatch there.
There is Bowen. Back to Dukas. Tries to go all the way. Does succeed. Well done. Nice work.
Some of the footwork enhanced by these Centre of Excellence boys is fantastic. So they're outside, you think they're going to shoot it, and they just run right by you.
Off hands, about four sets, doesn't matter, lands in Braves' hands. The Bendigo crowd's happy with that. Turner, clock is winding. He sneaks in. You get under your door with a little sneaky shot like that. You know, he came from nowhere.
He didn't sneak in, he barged in.
He did, good
demanded
call.
Demanded the points.
Right behind Goodrick, doesn't get there.
Good rebound.
Kunin. Got one to beat. Daniels takes the foul.
Yeah, he
puts
took the
hand
foul.
Up.
Yeah, he had to take that foul. There was a huge mismatch. Give his arm a bit of a slap and go, and you can go to the line if you want the points. Very smart play.
Super U live streaming. Thanks to City Copy Centre in Queen Street. Greg and Janine, they'll look after you. And if you're not watching in Bendigo, they'll send you stuff.
They will.
Have plumbing or fix up your pipes too anywhere in Australia.
I really want to get the he's drained it for Pabst Plumbing in at some point today.
Well, we'll work it in, eh? Kunin,
yes.
Missed that. We watched the women before. It was a win for the Bendigo Braves women over the Centre of Excellence. They were terrific, though, the women, for the Centre of Excellence. Just couldn't keep the pace up and a win.
Yeah, scoreboard was not a true reflection. Oh, found
two
a
miss.
Way to...
Oh, and I was going to say the coach wouldn't be happy. No coach would be. And I think we might have dragged a foul here. It'll be on Kyle Bowen from the Centre of Excellence.
I know a few coaches that would be flipping their lid. David Hogan's not one of those, but you've got to box out. Shouldn't be beating that situation. That's Dave. Just it's mental, that.
David Hogan, the new coach.
I can remember the old coach would have got lost his.
Yeah, he'll be up in the grandstand watching and probably fuming. Here's Johnston. Tries to go all the way. Got a few to beat. Back to Andronicus. He loves this situation. Doesn't get there. Good hands. Kyle Bowen says, I'll take you on, lads. Centre of excellence. Gives it up to Lees. Back on the court for the youngsters. Gets it back to Bowen. Bowen pushes.
Oh, my
Gonte,
God.
This is a good spot for the Centre of Excellence. Just can't make it, Lee. Geez, they look good. Just couldn't finish off. Here's Johnston for three. Gets there.
Had an open look. Had all day to make it. Didn't make it. Goes down the other end and drains a three thanks to Pab Plumbing.
See you, Lee. Back to Dukas. That's the way you respond. Three. Back to a three for Dukas. So they still lead by six.
Oh, he's got a goose step there.
Hogan, we've seen the moves from Deontay Burton so far. Here's Johnston again for three, doesn't get there. All Centre of Excellence, no blue shirts in there whatsoever.
I think if you made one, you're entitled to have another go. Didn't roll, though.
Dukas.
Oh, good pass.
Lost a little control in there. They still have it, though. Back to Dukas. Wasn't Dukas. That one's off hands. Should be an easy basket for Bowen and his. Good time for a timeout, thanks to the City Copy Centre.
These Centre of Excellence boys, they've got really quick feet. They're just driving by the guards of the Bendigo and getting to the rack. I'm amazed Bendigo's not in foul trouble because they just keep getting there. They're fantastic with and they've got an outside game, so you've got to guard them, you've got to be up on them, you've got to have a hand in their face, and then they blow by you. And not much you can do about that, it's just too good.
So the other game is the Hobart Huskies, they're called.
Huskies.
Another Wadding Spectres, and it's a big lead.
Yeah, it's
in that one there.
It's blown out the 20 points. I was about to say 22. Hobart's just scored a minute 59 to go in that one. 20 points in basketball, still half to go. It's not insurmountable, but not looking good for Hobart. It's just like the Tasmanian teams are really tough down there.
Yeah, they certainly are. And the thing, too, is that that was on NBL One live streaming. So if you want to have a look at that match, go for it. But certainly stick with us. Come back and have a look at this game because it's not a bad one. It is the Centre of Excellence up by 8. We're in a timeout, by the way, for the City Copy Centre and Pav Plumbing. Super U live streaming right around Australia and the world.
Yeah, Goodrick with 13 points and Lee's got 9. Ray Turner has all of a sudden gotten the game with 8 and 9 rebounds. And Deontay Burton. As I said, I'm liking his team play. 4 assists, just put the shot away. Just for a little bit.
So, sit up again.
Here we go,
right across the region and certainly Australia, live streaming around the world, in fact. Deontay Burton tried to go all the way, does succeed. So that'll give him a little bit of confidence, the new recruit for the Braves.
Nothing wrong with that. It's hard to miss those. So he proved me wrong.
Foul will be on Cowling.
He's shaking his head. He doesn't believe that that's a foul. But referees all around the world, Deontay, they have different interpretations.
They certainly do. That's exactly right. He's got to get used to that real quick. Johnston takes a break for the Braves. And Tanner Rayner is back, or in for his first time on the court. Well, look, nice and strong around the ring, the centre of excellence. Let's just say, just a fantastic block.
Get out of my house.
Andronicus. Gee, that was very diplomatic.
Yeah, you're not welcome. Oh, beautiful.
Nice work and finish from Burton, so more points for Deontay Burton.
Yeah,
Andronicus strong though, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was very strong. It gets your team going too, a big block like that.
Lee, turn around. Here we go for 3. Beautiful work from Alex Dukas.
Another guy with a very sweet stroke. Just beautiful outside shooting team. Here we go.
Here's Burton for 3 and gets there.
Burton's just proved I've known nothing about basketball. He's just racked up 7 points in a minute. 2 drives to the bucket and the 3. So he's feeling it now.
But that's what you want your import to do. I mean, you know, they can have bad periods, but if they can do something like that in the space of a couple of minutes, that's the reason you got them, basically.
Yeah, you want imports. You want imports to score. If they don't score, then they're not much good to you, to be honest. Because Bendigo does have a guard issue, so they've brought him in. And so far, he looks the goods. Early days, you're a bit rusty, but he's racked some points there. Couldn't make a shot early. He's just made the last 3.
Thanks to City Copy Centre. Yeah, you're right. And obviously, so far in the game, not far away from halftime, so we won't do the stats just as yet, but you'll see some on your screen anyway. Keep you updated.
Yeah, stats will roll through during the break, so you don't have to listen to too much of us. Probably not a bad thing. I hope Deontay doesn't watch the call back. I didn't mean anything I said. But the game feels closer than probably what it should be to me. But Braves are winning the quarter by a point, but the signs have been better. The scoreboard says, we're only a point better off. Their offense looks better. They've already scored 18 points in this quarter, which was, they only scored 14 in the first. So
this boy's been good, Isaiah Lee.
Yeah, Lee and Goodrick. The Dukas isn't bad either.
Yep. Just giving himself some stats there. This youngster's on the court for the first time. His name is Dendit. Remember that name.
Oh.
Goodrick. We take the foul.
They're not intimidated, these lads. They see a bigger body in front of them. They go, yeah, no, I'm going to take the foul for the team. I'm going to get myself to the line for a couple of freebies, please. And as I said, this guy has got a phenomenal shooting technique. There's nothing wrong with it whatsoever.
Technique's good. He's a lefty, too.
Yeah, you don't see many of them. Love a good lefty. and they're hard to guard because they generally take a step to the left, go with the hand you're not expecting. Just a bit short on that one.
Oh, nice work, Dengit. No.
Yeah, no, he just accidentally tipped it onto a Braves leg.
Take that too. Some changes. Kunin back for the centre of excellence. Kyan. Dennis takes a break. Lee, like what he saw, got it back though. Isaiah Lee. So he run it round the ring. Dengit.
Yeah, he's got a huge mismatch. Didn't want to take it.
No. Push the line. Got a couple of seconds left. Want to move it real quick. Buzzer beats him. So cheap one for the Braves, but good defense at the same time.
When you've got a mismatch like that, I know there's team structure and all those things, but you just got to put the ball up. He's a foot taller than Burton. Have a when you pan down the other screen, they're on each other at the moment. That's just like there's a huge size differential. Burton would like his chances outside against him. Too quick, but he's not going to get the opportunity.
No, that's exactly right.
But Braves are going to have to double team coming down the other way for Kunin because he's just too big. They made the switch they have. That's a better lineup.
Brian Coughlin with Adam Ellison here. All the way, Lee doesn't get there. Probably deserved it. Bartlett's back on the court for the Braves. Deontay takes it all the way. A bit easy for Deontay Burton.
Yeah, he looks like a driving player, as in he likes to take it to the hoop. Can shoot the ball, but yeah, he's not afraid to take it to the rack. We'll find out more about him as we see more of him.
That's exactly it. Big boy is Lucas Schmidt onto the court. Right behind this, doesn't get there for Goodrick. And they go again. Burton is there. He's into the game. In fact, it was Ray Turner. I apologise.
No, it was Burton with the assist. Burton's got about 7 points now, I think, maybe slightly more, 9. And he's providing some assists as well. He's playing a great game.
Lee, probably give it back to Goodrick. No. We'll get a couple of freebies here.
Yeah, Lee likes this little floater from just inside the key. It does a floater, does a finger roll. I think the Braves have just got to watch that scout that he is going to do it.
Certainly going to happen. So they lead by 1. Great comeback from the Bendigo Braves here at the Bendigo Stadium. Round 2. NBL 1 action. Hope you're enjoying the coverage. Tell all your friends because this is the norm when it comes to covering the new competition. We're all excited by it here in Bendigo, that's for sure. It's been good tonight, the youngster in Lee.
And a lot more streaming going on by all organisations, which is great for us as basketball fans, that we can see our teams. We can't get to the games, we can see them.
Look at Burton, all the way on. Dronicus thought about a dunk, didn't need to be cute, got the basket anyway.
Yeah, but back at the basketball, Burton's played in one heck of a second quarter.
Straight across, youngster in Dengit just gave it up. Coach won't be happy. Burton slows things down.
There's a 2 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Burton's been fantastic. He's got 6 assists and 9 points. So he's been outstanding this quarter and just doing a bit of clock management, Brian.
Burton, here he goes for 3. Doesn't get there. Andres has got some good hands in there. They've had some good looks, the Braves, and so have the centre of excellence. Big long shot was on offer by Goodrick, didn't make it. That is half-time. What's been a terrific first half, it is the centre of excellence. Here at the Bendigo Stadium, round 2 of NBL 1. I'll get it right. By 1 over the Bendigo Braves.
Plenty of NBA going on at the moment.
Yeah,
they're getting close to the playoff season there. Here we're at the start of our NBL 1 season. The first 30 seconds of the match wasn't that exciting. A dunk from Ray Turner and then a big three at the other end from Centre of Excellence. And she was game on. And it's been game on ever since. I'm really impressed with the Braves that quarter. They won that quarter by 4 points. 24 points compared to 14 in the first quarter. So they got their game going.
Yes, indeed. They needed to as well.
So defence, they kept... they kept the centre of excellence down to 20 points. So that's all right. But 19-20, that's manageable. I'd be happy with that. Yeah, and just got their offense going. I think Burton was a huge key to that. I was saying, don't shoot the ball, don't shoot the ball. He drove it to the rack three times and got the results, and then shot a nice three ball as well. For the center of excellence, they've got some boys that just know how to shoot the basketball. Goodrick with 14 points, Dukas with 10. I think Lee's up there in the numbers as well. He's got 11. And I won't go through it. Benio got their field goal for shooting percentage up to 43, so that's a decent number. Otherwise, the stats are pretty even.
Yeah, indeed.
Bendigo just dominating the points in the paint. They're plus 12 in that. And when you got Ray Turner on your side, you generally win that stat.
Usually the case as well. Any other stats before we have a halftime break here at the Bendigo Stadium, Adam?
No, I think Bendigo's bench has actually been quite impressive. They're plus 7 against... So they've scored 9 points. It was something I was very worried about coming into the season. It'd have to be all the starters, but so far they've proven me wrong too. So it's just a really good game of basketball. Could go either way, and I'm really looking forward to the second half.
Yes, indeed. We'll be back with that action soon. We'll catch up with, hopefully, one of the guys from the men and just chat about that first half. We won't do it right now. Take a break. It is the Braves trailing the Centre of Excellence 39-38. Thanks to City Copy Centre and also PAV Plumbing. Super U live streaming around Australia. We'll be back very soon.
Yeah. you explain that for us, Tim?
We didn't teach him football, but we did teach him the word frothy that he's never heard before. So if anybody wants to buy him one after the game, I'm sure he'd appreciate his first full Australian beer.
As an elite athlete, I'm not sure he'll take that up, but we appreciate the offer, and I can see you enjoying it coming yourself. Bishop, what did you expect to come here and see at the Bendigo Rovers home game? Were you expecting anything in particular? Well, that's a good start, right? The good people are Bendigo doing lots of basketball. Is there anything any players you'd like to give me on the microphone? Anything you'd like to see done differently? Thank you. I'll give you that check a little later. Ladies and gentlemen, Fisher and Tim, 91.9 in the morning on the hits. Hey, I've forgotten the Dean Payne. That's... Oh, now you leave your stuff there. I'll sit in the middle. The rows between two balls, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here with the Dean Payne and Maddie Sexton. Mads, not soon enough tonight, mate, but you will be taking the floor tomorrow on Ballarat, is that correct? Yeah. I've got the inside scoop for the game. I didn't go in the wrong room here and all that, but hey, mate, tonight the girls were pretty good in that last quarter. You see, I went and pushed them all the way for three quarters. Did you guys expect that coming in?
100%. We knew that those girls are tough. We're all about the game. They're coaching really well too, but always tough. It was a danger game for us.
Well, most of the time I see them drinking lattes and I'm making you in the bar, mate. So if they're working and you're drinking lattes, I'm pretty sure I know how that's going to play out. Hey, but all the best for tomorrow night in Ballarat. We'll know you'll get up to them. Maddie Sexton, mate, welcome back to the Bendigo Stadium. A brief stint in the US at college. Is it good to be back and just have the home floor underneath your feet, mate?
Yeah, definitely good to be back. Although, outside
of the
court this season, so it's nice to see
the girls on the
court.
And a little rumour I heard is that you're going to run around playing netball this season, is that correct? And any insider scoop on where that might be, 2016?
At Santos this season.
Fantastic. Well, if you want to get along and see some quality netball, you can head along and see our very own Maddie Sexton. Thanks for having a chat with you guys. Good running, Brian. And now I'm here, I think. I apologize. Hey, thanks for doing this too. Awesome work. Keeping the players safe. I love it. Is it alright if I sit here with you guys? Are you scared of the microphone, my brother? Oh, I don't mind. I just hate it, so I'm all good. What's your name, mate? Chase, that's a cool name, bro. What are you doing here on the couch? Are you just enjoying the best seats in the house, Chase? Chase, did you know that you can't actually buy these seats? You must face somebody pretty important. Who do you know who's bring the rails? Matt Bartlett. You know Matt Bartlett?
From here.
Yeah.
So probably else chat with?
So you're using a smaller camera?
I want to bring it to you. I'll chat with you, Trent Leach. Trent, sitting at the end of the bench tonight, mate. You feeling good about how we come over the second half?
I caught up with Wes last night. He has all the camera operators that do his footy games. So I'm thinking, okay, he does a lot of belly, that's
cool.
Oh, he's one of the young guys who did the Mildura match last year, the granny. It was fucking terrible when I went.
Oh, yes. You'll be learning absolutely nothing from Taylor.
I think what they think is
going to be at this point.
He
has got a nice head.
They think
he's looking very sharp.
And I know he gets nervous, but I'd rather pay him and not have a jump for him if he uses an SD card in his phone. Because I've got all the headsets.
He's got a camera in his phone.
The key, I mean, for these guys, the key is the camera.
You got the stats?
Welcome back to the Bendigo Stadium NBL 1 action. It is the Bendigo Braves versus the Centre of Excellence. They lead by one, the Centre of Excellence, thanks to City Copy Centre and also Pav Plumbing. Adam Elephant's with me. I'm Brian Coughlin, and the ex-coach, the guy tonight who watches a game without being a coach, is Ben Harvey, the legendary man from the Bendigo Braves and many other clubs. Harves, how are you, mate?
Yeah, very good, thank you. Yourself?
I just worry about you, mate, because you're a coach for a long time today. Well, tonight's your first time kind of out of whack. How's it feeling?
No, very good, actually. I haven't actually seen much of the game, to be honest, but running around and, you know, we've got a great crowd here today.
Oh, it's terrific, isn't it? Yeah, it's great.
I'd say about 1,800 people here tonight, and to be honest, it's a great atmosphere. And, I mean, at the end of the day, the Centre of Excellence boys, I mean, aren't they, you know, they're the best kids in the country. And, our boys are doing okay. I mean, they start off a bit slow, but at the end of the day, you know, we're down by one. You know, it's anyone's game right now, but I think at the end of the day, it's going to be about who's going to get that run. So, yeah, we're looking forward to that.
Yeah, and you'd be happy round two. How are you going? Let's get back to you, Dodd's question. How are you going? Are you watching plays where you go, I wouldn't have done that? Now, we saw a couple of plays, Adam, that you would have, if you had any hair, you would have ripped it out.
Oh, well, when they got an offensive rebound off a three throw, I'm sure you would have spat your toys right out of the cot. But anyway, I want to speak about the coach, mate. What's with his dress sense?
Actually, he looks really smart, I think.
I think he does,
you
too.
Know, I suppose it's, you know, lifting the standard. I mean, obviously the NBL won now. It's fantastic to know that, obviously the NBL are part of this now. And it's, you know, I mean, you look at this facility. I mean, this is a world-class facility and an NBL arena, mind you. But coming back to David, rookie year, he's looking fantastic. He's got a great team around him. Justin Cass, Michael Gibbons, Taylor Bell. You know, as you know, you've got to surround yourself around good people, and he's done that. And I think there's no doubt he's put a fantastic team on the floor, and I wish him and all the team the very best.
There's a little bit of gelling to be done. I think you'll obviously be a better side by round five or six. You can't expect import to come in and just, well, he's done very well, but gee, it's a tough gig, isn't it, coming all the way from overseas.
Yeah, there's no doubt. He was here on Tuesday, and could have even been Wednesday. But 9 points, 6 assists so far. There's no doubt. I mean, he plays very well. He's played at a very high level and across other countries, and he can create for others, which is great, and he can also score. But I mean, that first play with Deontay Burton and Ray Turner, I did see that.
Love
one
it.
And that was a nice little play. But we're 10 seconds away, and you guys are doing a great job. I mean, this is fantastic. What a great crowd right now, and let's hopefully the Braves come with a run like the women did
last game.
They come with that last minute run, and I think, you know, it's whoever's going to get that next run, I think, is going to win the game.
We're nearly out of time. Just quickly, the days gone by, especially in playing days, these guys would get smashed by 30, 40. These days, they are obviously, you know, they are super competitive. They've already won a game against Dandenong, so they're up for it, aren't they, the Centre of Excellence?
There's no doubt, Cogger. I mean, these kids go to the best Division One, colleges in America. So, I mean, you know, these kids can play, and they're not going to back down whether they're 16 or 18. They're going to, obviously, Hogan's getting ready to the ball. But good luck for you guys, and let's go Braves.
Thanks, Harv. Ben Harvey there, all part of the action here at the Bendigo Stadium. Long-time coach of the Braves, of course, and I think he's lying a bit to us, Adam. I think he is a bit he's struggling a bit with not coaching.
Let's see how the win-loss record is and then see how involved he gets. I'm pretty sure he'll be pretty hands-off. As he said, they've got JC over there and Taylor Bell. And
well, you've got Justin Cass, you've got Taylor Bell, and also Hoags himself, the coach. There's possibly 700-plus games of basketball experience.
Oh, Michael Gibbons as well. I knew I was leaving one out. They've got...
Well, we just missed that. You'll see it on your screen there. But, gee, fantastic work by Dyson Daniels. 16-year-old. Got the ball back for his club. Still got the quarter, the halftime score. Ray Turner might fix that up. Tries to go for Andronicus, a little bit too much strength, but we'll draw the foul.
Yeah, they're playing with size. They're playing with Turner and Andronicus on the floor at the moment. So just trying to outsize the Centre of Excellence at the moment. And this is the part of Mickey's game. Oh, Mick Andronicus, Matt Andronicus. It's not my favourite part of the game.
No,
that was all right. Oh, he's going to get the roll.
First time they've led tonight, with the exception of the first score of the game. So it's been a long time between drinks for the Bendigo Braves. They go for the centre of excellence. Lost it. Who's going to get it?
Oh, it's called over and back.
So unfortunate for the centre of excellence.
So, yeah, backcourt. Deemed that they didn't lose possession. Probably fair call.
So second half has started off a lot slower than...
Yeah, it's a bit flat at the moment, isn't it? People are coming back into the stadium. We didn't get that sensational dunk to start the half. No one's scoring.
Burton, Andronicus, a little loose. Can't get there. Good work in close by Goodrick. Teammate is Dukas that had it. Koonin back to Goodrick. Threes on offer, gets it.
I'm going to keep saying it. He's just got a beautiful stroke.
Well, this is the talent coming through for Australian basketball, the centre of excellence. Coach is trying to explain to his players.
Yeah, so like Harv said, basically the pathway for these kids as they go play American college basketball, they come into NBL 1, NBL. That's how good they are.
So Hogan. This is the recruit, Deontay Burton. Hogan. Still take a few games for these guys to gel together. Ray Turner looks good from this angle. Not too good there. And Koonin for the centre of excellence to Lee. Lee's been terrific. Nice little pass off. Didn't get there. Oh. Nearly tapped it in himself as Ray Turner. Is that an own goal?
No own goals, but that would have gone to the shooter.
Just can't get a handle on it, Ray. He just said, how's your mother? And that's probably the worst way to go about it, is give it up. Oh, well, it off hands. It'll still be a ball for the centre of excellence to bring back into play.
That's great play by Burton. Give up the foul, or if you can get the ball clean, even better. Just great team basketball. Covered for his mate.
So, lucky work. They've taken some risks here. Koonin nearly gave it up. Got it back to Dukas. He ran a fair distance. He'll drag the foul as Koonin has a bit of a yak to the coach.
Ray Turner was a bit lost in defense there. He's just running here, there, and everywhere, waving the arms and running around in circles. And in the end, gave up the foul. No, it's been ugly basketball in the second half. It'll get better, folks.
So
I don't know when, but it'll get better.
Yeah, we'll put the timer on that. We'll see what happens. They lead by two, the centre of excellence. This young bloke has shown the Bendigo crowd that he's going to be a player of the future. Tucks it round to Andronicus, who does the old half dunk.
Gets a jam.
That'll do us. They're back, though. Don't muck around the centre of excellence. Back through Goodrick. Gets the call up from Bowen. Goodrick, Bowen's got it, still got it. In the way is Burton.
Beautiful off the window.
Might have been Ray Turner, it was.
You've got to be careful when you bounce pass into the key. There's lots of hands that can get in the way with it, but it was a good pass.
So Turner sets up for Burton. Little underpass. Andronicus has been good around the ring, gets the points, takes the foul. Everyone's happy in a Bendigo blue shirt.
Yeah, good little dribble spin move by Andronicus coming back onto his favourite right hand for the and one. Good basketball. As I said, the game would get better in the last couple of minutes. Both teams have found a bit of offence. Oh, that was always short.
Yeah, it was short, but I tell you what, defence, you've got to make the most of it. The only one that bent down to get it was the bloke's probably the oldest there, Chris Hogan. He did. Here's the youngest bloke on the court. Oh, Dyson Daniels misses.
Yeah, no, good play though. Nothing wrong with the play. Just hit the back of the iron.
Lee pushes Burton out of the way and takes the foul.
He's busy, Burton, isn't he? It's only his second foul.
Not him, his first.
Well, there you go. Once again, I've beaten the scoreboard operator. He doesn't give up any soft points. He's not going to give you a layup unless he's... I presume if he gets in foul trouble, he's going to have to. But in general, you're going to earn your money when he's defending you.
Slides that one in. You've got 13 points so far, Lee. Dukas for the centre of excellence, leading on 16 and 12 for Andronicus. Not a bad share for the Braves, just don't have enough at the minute. They trail by two.
Yeah, Turner's got 10, which is what we expected. The big boy's inside, but Andronicus is not on the floor now.
Mangan is back on the court for him, for the Braves. Cowling's in there too. Lots of hands. Big Banjo was in there. He couldn't get a finger on it. As they make their way to the basket, Banjo, Talbot. Back to Tattersall. He's under pressure. Lee pushes the youngster or tries to out of the way. Good defensively was Daniels. Over the top. Still got some hands in there. It's an ugly ball. Or an ugly play, I should say. Nothing wrong with the ball. Another foul.
Yeah, Bendigo gone really small here. No Andronicus and no Turner on the floor, which takes away 22 of the points you've scored. So it takes away half your scoring ability as well. So dangerous period for the Braves, I reckon.
As we watch Kyle Bowen.
I haven't seen a great deal of free throw shooting that's any good in either game tonight.
So, setting up again, they lead by three, the centre of excellence. The Bendigo Braves will be off to Ballarat tomorrow night to take on the Ballarat Miners. Nice long throw. Lost a little handle on it, was Mangan.
New league, same rivalry, Brian.
Oh, yeah. That one's at the Minor Dome in Ballarat, live through NBL 1. Just jump on the fixture or the Ballarat page and you'll be able to go live and have a look at what's going on.
No matter where the teams are on the ladder, they play hard basketball. It'll be a really good game to tune into. Open shot.
Yeah, it wasn't there, though, unfortunately, for Dennis. They've still got the ball. Here we go for three. Nice work by Will Tattersall.
Haven't seen much of Will, but it looked good, didn't it?
Certainly did.
His lucky number came up, Brian.
I wasn't going with anything like that tonight. I knew what you were going to do. Here's Burton. Gives it back to Mangan to Hansen for three. Yes. Crowd like it.
That's his job, Dan Hansen. He's a good three-ball shooter. You get a good look, go for it.
Lee pushes Cowling out of the way. Might have stood on his foot.
Yeah, stood on the foot and drew the foul. Good basketball. Like I said, they play a very aggressive brand of basketball at the Center of Excellence. They're not afraid to take it to the hoop. And they've got these perimeter shooters that are fantastic.
So they lead by three. Opportunity to open up a little more. Lee, terrific.
How you shut them down, I don't know. I think David Hogan probably knows, but it's another thing doing it.
So they haven't made too many changes tonight. Mind you, Lee's he's been terrific. Has a rest. And Hunter Goodrick, who's been good too, comes on for the centre of excellence. They're in front by five. Halfway through this third term for the City Copy Centre and also Pav Plumbing.
Yeah, they've got a few players that have racked up, three players on the floor at the moment, they've racked up 19, 20 minutes, which is quite a lot considering the game's only 25 minutes old.
Lloyd gave it to Hansen. Ray Turner, what is he like? He sees Mangan in the corner. Good work from Jordan Mangan. Haven't said his name a lot. He certainly made a little difference to the scoreboard there. Long shot is on here, and if you can do it, I can do it, says Hunter Goodrick.
Keep saying it. He's got a sweet stroke.
14 points so far for him. Lee's got 15. As the long shot was on, great steal. Oh, hang on, the refs pull this up. He just may have stepped out. He did.
Oh, that's unlucky. I love his attack on the basketball there too. It's the in-ball, the Turner. He just went up and gone, I'll have it. So doing it at both ends of the court. Basketball, you've got to defend and you've got to attack. You've got to be able to, well, some players get away with not having both sets of skills, but helps if you've got them both.
Get found out at some stage, don't you? Loose ball, yes. Well done. Centre of excellence through Goodrick. Couldn't get a handle on it either. It was Keon Dennis.
An NBL player that I love is Damian Martin, who just hustles and plays great defence, and he's a defensive player, but if he needs to shoot a ball, he's reliable.
Yeah, that's it, Daniels.
Andrew Gaze, the legend, wasn't much of a defender, but when you're putting 40 points on your board for your team each week, I don't really think they cared if he was willing to defend.
No, that's it. Lloyd. Got a couple to beat there. They attacked him. Let him answer the picnic. And nearly stolen, but taken back. And what nice work by Turner. See, the good pressure from the centre of excellence.
You're 100% right. That's where they want Ray Turner shooting the ball. He's doing a fadeaway jumper from the top of the key. That's not his go. So it was excellent defense. Ray just too good. But, hey, mate, keep making him see if he can keep doing it. Another drive to the bucket, kick out, shoot, bang.
Nearly there. Would have made a difference. Andronicus, he's quick on his feet, but these boys are a little quicker. That should be an easy basket. A bit cute from Dennis. Might be made to pay here. There's the youngster in Lloyd. Daniels from Turner to Hanson. Andronicus got two to beat. He's got the muscle. We know he does. This time he misses it, but he'll drag a foul.
Yeah, they've gone tall again, Bendigo. I think that was just the rest of their big blows for just a couple of minutes, and David Hogan didn't persist with it long. Didn't hurt him. This is where they look dangerous, getting the ball into Turner. And Andronicus especially has really owned the paint.
That's it.
I'd be quite happy to foul him, though. I'd check his free throw shooting numbers. Yeah, he's 2 of 6. Keep sending him there. And teams do this. They do scouts. They know who they can send to the line and who they can't. Oh, that was a terrible shot.
So we're back into it. Third quarter action. And they'll set up again. The centre of excellence. They lead by 4 here in Bendigo. Live streaming through Super U on the NBL 1 website. Foul on again.
Yeah, they're hard to predict what they're going to do, the centre excellent boys, whether they're going to shoot it from outside or drive it inside, but more often than not, they don't pass the ball to the centre. They don't have a traditional centre back to the bucket try and turn, but what they do is that they're outside perimeter players just beat people on the outside and get to the hoop that way. If they had a unit that was big enough, they could probably play a centre. But yeah, they basically play a mobile centre in there.
Alex Dukas with point number 18. He's been terrific tonight. Lee's got 15, also been terrific. He takes a break, so they freshen up. 6-point leaders at the moment, thanks to the City Copy Centre. Daniels. Hanson just need to steady up. Who got hands on it? Well, Lee says, I don't reckon I did, but ref says you did, buddy.
I think he's just asking Daniels whether he touched it last. I don't know.
So they go again. The Bendigo Bros here in Bendigo. Hogan back to Hanson to Lloyd. Andronicus is screaming for it. He's got two to beat. It's going to be a little bit difficult. Lloyd will have to go now with the time, and he gets it in just on buzzer time.
Well called, Brian, and well played by Andronicus. He knew he couldn't put up the shot. He was double-teamed, and Lloyd taking the shot and delivering.
Lee. Comes back to Dennis. Lee's got it. Been terrific tonight. He'll drag another foul. Andronicus is into his third.
Yeah, and 2 minutes 26 and into the bonus foul-wise, so you can be guaranteed the centre of excellence will keep taking it to the rack. That's three for Andronicus, which means he has to sit down. So some bad, just a bad, this could be a really crucial couple of minutes with Andronicus off the floor. Three fouls. Don't know what the delay is. Here we go. Got a few lefties in this team, the centre of excellence. They're right on top in this game.
Yeah, I was about to say that. It is a danger period. You're right about Droniger's foul trouble. And certainly Turner's got a couple as well. Wouldn't want one more at this stage of the game. Daniels could go all the way. Probably just doesn't have the muscle to wedge it in there. This bloke does. Should get it and does. Ray Turner. So round two action just keeps that in, Coonan. Lee, time to set up again. Clock starting to wind. You can see that on the Super U scoreboard there. Back to Coonan. Got to be quick. Runs into a wall of players. Here's Lee for three. Had a ring to it. Some hands. And they were centre of excellence hands. So it'll be a Braves ball.
Yeah, didn't panic there, even though it was a couple of seconds on the clock. I don't know how we got that pass out of it. Unbelievable, just couldn't make the shot.
Gone for a little more pace now with Bartlett and also the import, Deontay
Burton
on the court. I was going to say Berger for some reason, I don't know why. Probably feel like one. Here we go, Burton.
Well, I had been calling him Dion, so between us we got it right.
Deontay, he's got it. He's the number one for the Braves. Gives it to his good mate Ray Turner. Tried to get around, lost it for a second. He'll go this time, Ray Turner. Needed the points. So trail by four.
Yeah, they're happy to give that shot to Ray, and he'll make a few, but a fadeaway jumper. It's not a percentage shot.
No, it's not. He doesn't have much help in the paint either. Here we go. Back to Talbot. Across there was the youngster. He did make it. Still got the ball, though, the centre of excellence. Tried to jump. Nice work by the youngster Lloyd in there. So they looked the goods, the centre of excellence. Stengett was looking good in there, but you still got to score. Here we go. Hogan, been here before, doesn't get there. Not one you'd often see Chris Hogan miss there. Didn't get anywhere near it. Dennis gave it up. Bowen, confidence with the centre of excellence, starting to do a few things right. And point.
Well played. He had a huge mismatch there on Lloyd, and just beautiful little step and easy bucket.
Hogan, now Lloyd. Last 30 seconds, third term for the City Copy Centre. Need to make every post to win it. Bartlett got about four blokes to run into, gives it up. Coach killer at the end if they can get some points here, the centre of excellence. Suck up the clock as they do. Bowen lost it. I might just reset the clock in a...
What was Bartlett thinking there? Trying to run through closed doors. Anyway.
Still a second left.
Yeah, second and a half, and it's a long time in basketball. Get your best out. Is Hanson on the floor?
Hanson's having a break at the minute.
I'd be just get it to Hanson, chuck up a three. Or you just chuck it up into Ray and go get it. Chuck it down with a second.
Yeah, got to make it, and got to make it quick. Here we go. Here's Ray Turner. Got to get there. Doesn't.
I should be a coach, Brian.
Well, let's see how the coach goes. He's about to chat to the lads. Three-quarter time here at the Bendigo Stadium. The centre of excellence is six up over the Braves. And I tell you what, it'd want to be a lot better than what we've seen in the first three quarters, because the centre of excellence have been well and truly on top.
Yeah, they won that quarter by five. Very good. Just quickly, it's coming to an end down in Hobart. Nutter Wadding getting the job done there, 89-65 over Hobart. So you can turn that one off. Keep watching us. We've got a live game here. 6 points the diff. Lee, outstanding with 17. He's been fantastic. Dukas with 18. Goodrick, who I just love his stroke, 14. Ray Turner's got 14. Andronicus, 12. And that's where the points are going to come from. The Braves, Captain Obvious there. Burton's got 9. I don't think he didn't score in that quarter. Having said that, he was on the bench for most of
it. Well, that's it. Yeah, it's hard to score from there.
Very, very hard to score on the floor. Braves have got a better shooting percentage, 42% from the field to 34. So you think, geez, if the centre of excellence actually made a few more shots, this one would be done.
You'd think so. And similar to the women. The women, Braves women had a win tonight, but gee, they had a lot of looks, the girls, similar like the men, and just missed out. But that's experience. They're all under the age of 19.
So points in the paint is a stat we expected Bendigo to dominate, and they have. They're 34 to 18. Second chance points I love as a stat. It just shows your commitment, your offensive rebounding, and centre of excellence. They're winning that 12 to 8. And they just got hustle, haven't they? They see a ball, they go for it. They're play very attacking basketball, but they defend up the other end. They're not physically intimidated by the bigger boys, the Bendigo Braves. They're not letting Turner and Andronicus push them around. They're very good. It's been that corner quarter started off a bit flat, but then got going. Anyone's game. I like the centre of excellence from here. 6 points is a nice lead, but it's only 2 scoring shots, basically. I just think they've got more shooting options. But then again, if Turner and Burton get hot, especially Burton, then that could be game on. But yeah, the points are only going to... They're limited avenues for the Braves. So we're underway in the last with the centre of excellence ball.
So here we go, last quarter action for the City Copy Centre and Pav Plumbing. Braves need to start big time. I know that's Captain Obvious. That does not help. Fantastic basket.
Get down to Copy Centre and get a photo of that.
Alex Dukas has been terrific. Point number 21.
Oh, that's what you want up on your wall from the Bendigo Copy Centre.
So just been real good. Little hand on it there. They've still got the ball, the centre of excellence. Wouldn't want to let it blow out too much. Here's Dukas again. He's been terrific. Gives it to the youngster in Goodrick.
They're the only ones they've really missed are the wide open ones. So just too much time.
Set up their defense really well. Centre of excellence. Coach would be pretty wrapped with what's happened tonight.
This is not the Bendigo's play. Ray on the dribble.
Doesn't get there. Hasn't got there all night in that position.
Just that is not what they'd be working on at training. That is not the play.
Defense, they're letting him have the outside shot here.
Yeah,
which their kids, they'll enjoy it. They don't think about anything like that. They just want to get it in.
Back him in. Great play.
Coonan travels.
Bad luck.
Yeah, it's stiff.
Yeah, he's backing Hogan in, and eventually just got his feet muddled, but... I just love the aggression because I hate to say it, that's men's basketball. That's where he's going. Okay, we're big boys game, big boys basketball. I'm just going to keep backing your back. Yeah, they're not intimidated, these young men. They're great.
So, Bartlett, somebody's got to get a spark into the team. Who's it going to be? Hogan. We know Daniels is trying hard. He gives it over to Ray Turner, as you said, wrong spot for him. Daniels got to push all the way to the line. The 15-year-old doesn't get there, takes the foul.
No, but he chose the right option. As the time is running out, get to the rack. Maybe if he draws in a defender, then he can get the ball off to Ray. And Ray, that's where Ray wants to be shooting the ball. So he's got the basketball smarts.
So Dyson Daniels. Doesn't get that one. Needed it.
Yeah, 9 points. You just got to be careful. What they need is just a couple of stops to get it below 5 or 6. And
So they sit up again. They lead by eight. The centre of excellence. Really good basketball all night from the boys. Lots of looks. Probably missed a lot they should have got. But that's history. Here they go again. Through Bowen. Little lap shot over the top. That was smart and cute and got the points they desired.
I was saying that they don't have a back-to-basket centre. Well, that's a back-to-basket centre right there. Just backing him in and then a little baby hook shot for the money.
Hogan for three. Desperately needed. Doesn't get there. Turner might have got someone hanging on to him. He did, so he'll take the foul.
They've got to change something up, Braves. They've either got to get some stops at one end or start shooting the lights out at the other, because I think momentum says that they're just starting to slide away.
So Hansen, backcourt. Hogan runs into a wall. Close things up nicely, the centre of excellence with their defence. Daniels still got two to beat here. The youngster gives it back to Turner. Needs to be quick. And doesn't get there. Andronicus, as the clock winds back to 14. He's tried hard. Who's going to? Daniels in there too. Right spot, right time. Fantastic strength in there by the centre of excellence, but certain the pressure is immense.
Great block.
Yeah, it was a great block. Again. Just need that spark.
Although it's been called a foul. That's okay, not a great block. Well, no, I'm going to say a great block. Fourth foul, 7 minutes. Then you've got to sit him down. If it's on Andronicus, which it is, according to the board, he's got to take a seat. And he ain't. He has to.
Yeah, timely as well here at the Bendigo Stadium.
Yeah, probably a timeout that had to be called. It's 12 points. You just felt the momentum getting away from the Braves. Offensively, they're just stagnant in this quarter. They got 1 point from the three throw line. Ray Turner's doing these fadeaway jumpers. It's not his fault. He's not getting the ball under the bucket like he wants it. Like he wants to get the ball. So I just don't know how the Braves are going to score points. Well done, the centre of excellence. As I said, they've been pushing him around. They've been keeping him out of the dangerous space. And that's full credit to the scout and the work of the lads that are keeping him out. Just some stats. Dukas has had a great game with 21 points and 19 for Lee. They've been fantastic. Goodrick with 14. Yeah, Turner and Andronicus with 14 and 12 for the Braves. But they've got to get some offense going. I just don't know how they're going to get it going, because their options are very, very limited.
Yeah, they are indeed.
And with Andronicus with four fouls, you'd say he's got to take a seat, which leaves Burton... Probably Burton and Ray Turner to get the points.
All right, here we go. Let's see where the spark's going to come from the Bendigo Bank Braves. Burton. Try and go all the way. Runs into a couple. That's better. Deontay Burton.
They've obviously got him on a plan of limited minutes. I'd say he backs up again tomorrow night. Just flew into the country, but... what we've seen of him's been good.
Tattersall, Lee, he's talking about being good. He's been terrific for the centre of excellence. They played well, little hand on there. Whose hand did it come off?
Good weak side defence by Hogan coming across and helping out.
And it's a Braves ball, so a little bit of luck going their way. That might be the thing that turns things around. A trail by 10, 6:38 to go. Final quarter action, I should say, for...
I like you. You're an optimist. That's
that is just terrible. If that's a turnover,
no, it's not a turnover. But
very lucky.
Sloppy.
So but Hogan will do it all again.
It's just not quite clicking for the Braves, is it? Then it's just like they're not in sync. I'll look at the turnovers, because it's not You usually get a lot of turnovers high in the season. Braves 11, Centre of Excellence 9. That's okay. That's manageable. You set those numbers.
So let's see what happens with the Bendigo Braves, wherever you're watching through the many streams. Given up, though.
Oh,
no.
Has to be against Bendigo.
So it is.
Yeah, fouls on Burton. So he just had a bit of a grab after the steal. So
a real foul trouble for him on two. So everything's okay there. It'll be the youngster in Lee.
The problem is that he's been called for an intentional foul. So that's two shots and possession. So that's one that you don't want to be given away.
Not at this stage of the game. Brings it back to 12.
Yeah, it's two in possession. It's a killer. It's a potential 4 or 5 point play. I love the rule.
So they go again, the centre of excellence. We've been watching tonight probably the cream of basketball across Australia. Good grab. Still got it in there. It was Bowen. Gives it across to the youngster in Dennis, and he says, thank you, mother, for the Rabbits. They are 14 in front.
It ain't over, but it's not looking good, Braves fans.
Hogan. Always be optimistic. Here's Burton. Daniels tries to give him a little bit of support there. Went through.
He can be proud of his first game in NBL 1.
Play at home, you mean? He played last week.
Oh, yeah, but in front of his home fans, he's played smart basketball. He's done everything he can.
So Daniels, try and claw it back. Good start. Mum and Dad are up in the crowd, I'd suggest, having a look. He pops a couple in, righto.
They've got to get some defense going. They've just got to get some stops. You reckon Centre of Excellence get to about 80, she's game over.
That's not going to help with a foul on Turner. Gives you three.
Don't think they're going to call that a shooting foul. I think they are calling that a shooting foul. Fair enough. I don't know what game I'm watching.
So back to what we've been talking, 14 points, not insurmountable, but spark required. Centre of Excellence would be just stoked. And here we go with this, just a turnover. He lost it too, so he gets it back. Johnston, big loss, long one. Here's Hogan for a couple. He doesn't get there. I don't think they want to take a Tats ticket for tomorrow night. They play the Ballarat tomorrow night, so you better hope everything comes together off the ring. Hogan. You gave it up.
That 60 seconds of basketball is on the internet forever.
Yeah, it is. You're right.
You can't erase the tape, but it wasn't pretty. Yeah, Braves. We've got a timeout. Braves. Saturday night. The old enemy, Ballarat. And the cheerleaders have come out to do their act, and we've got confusion because there's a sub and not a timeout.
Okay, all right.
Off you go.
So refs are okay now. Everyone's in slow motion at the minute, I would have thought. So still with the centre of excellence. Nice long one out to Bowen. He pushes. Knows what he wants. Keeps his teammate open. Beautiful defence, though, by Burton.
That was a great play and then great defence.
Here's
beautiful
Dyson Daniels. Should get there, Ray Turner, and does where he needs to be. The defence was a little different on that occasion. And we got a little push and shove, I think, here.
Yeah, just a charge. That's a great pass by Dyson. That's what Ray Turner wants. He wants that ball down low. Let him go to work. Just a good couple of minutes here for the Braves.
Yeah, get it together now if they can do that for a couple of minutes. Bartlett's back on, he's quick. Adds a bit of pace to the side. Tried a few things tonight, Coach David Hogan. Here's Bartlett for three. This will help, doesn't get there. Big Ray does though. This is what they haven't been doing. Andronicus, Bartlett, Daniels. Nice work over the top. Ray's got a few to beat, does beat them. Grabs a couple back for the Braves. They trail by 10.
I just like that setup where Andronicus is further out and it's Turner under the hoop.
Lost it. Still a centre of excellence ball though.
Intensity of the game, the Braves game's gone up in the last couple of minutes though.
You're looking a bit tired, the centre of excellence boys. They've done a great job reminding you they're coming from Canberra, so it's a fair bus trip.
Or yeah, they fly down, but yeah,
fly they, down don't
have,
yep.
They don't have any home games. They play all their home games are played in Victoria.
Oh, okay.
That was part of the condition of them being in the comp, so they're just happy to be playing basketball.
Wouldn't be the worst job in the world, you wouldn't think.
Yeah.
Coonan.
It's not a long flight.
Back to Goodrick. Coonan again, got the height, doesn't get there, lots of hands.
Oh, that's got to be a foul.
Yeah, definitely a foul.
Well done to get the shot away and get it in. Just whether it's called an unsportsmanlike.
So, Kyle Bowen didn't appreciate it.
I think it was accidental. I think that's Andronicus's night done. Just a bit of confusion.
Well, he's gone off. He hasn't been fouled. Yes, he has now. Yeah. So that is the game for Andronicus.
It is being called an unsportsmanlike. The only difference is the possession. He was always going to get the extra shots.
So Dukas to pop one in.
Some real foul trouble for Bendigo here because one more and they're in the bonus as well. So they've got 14 points. Yeah, there's still time, but everything's got to go right.
Bit of a hush over the crowd here in Bendigo.
Yeah, they're a bit
waiting for something to happen, I would have thought.
They're a bit flat. It's a few delays. A few blokes hitting the floor. The poor mop boy. It's not a good job. I'm better than me.
So we're ready to roll once again here at the Bendigo Stadium.
No, players are taking over. They're not happy with the job. And fair enough, it's quite slippery. It's their livelihoods.
So yeah. Now we're right to roll. Everyone's happy. Mopping's been done. Dukas comes back with the ball. Steele was on, little tap in the air, off hands, who will get there, Andronicus. It wasn't him because he's off. Hansen, not sure how I got that wrong, he doesn't have any tattoos. Here's Hansen for three, needs it, doesn't get it, who's back there? Well done, Daniels, nice tap, had three to beat. Bartlett, this will be a long shot, won't get there, wasted shot. He knew what he wanted. He wanted Ray to jump up there and get it, but...
Oh, good. No, it was a shot. It wasn't a pass, so you're giving him credit where it's not due. It was just good defense, hand in the face, and Bartlett's really struggled with his shot tonight.
Dukas again got the most points for the team tonight. And just let it go. Nice job from him. 23 points so far, but he... loses possession. Still 14 points the difference. 3:24 to go. Final term for the City Copy Centre.
Yeah, this one's gone down the drain for the Braves. And if your drain is blocked, get on that Adam at Pav's Plumbing, Brian.
You had to get it in somehow. We're back here, not next Thursday, the Thursday after, before Easter.
Before Easter, big game.
The Bendigo Stadium.
I should remember the game, Brian, but I don't have it in front of me, but you are right, it's a Thursday night. Earlier on tonight, Nana Wadding defeated Hobart in the men's fixture, 93-72. some stats leaders in this game. They're all from the BACOE. 23 to Dukas, 23 to Lee. Ray Turner's the leading point scorer for the Braves with 18. He's pulled in 16 boards. So he's had a pretty solid game, Ray. But this one's just... This one, I don't think the centre of excellence will let it fizzle out. I think they'll want to go on with the business and get a nice win. And they'll walk away from Bendigo 2-2 and be pretty happy with their season. And so they bloody should be.
Exactly.
Brace, well, don't have time to dwell on the loss, mate. You just move on to tomorrow. You don't look at, you look at this game probably during the week. You don't worry about it today. That's the thing with double headers. Just get on the bus tomorrow, head down to Ballarat, try and get a W. Anytime you play two games in a weekend and you get one win, I reckon that's a good weekend. So let's see what Burton's got. Little dribble, little pass, little footwork.
Well, you need it when you come out of a timeout like that. You really need to get your act together and go hard.
Yeah,
I just haven't seen that, exception of about the first minute of the game for the Braves. Sense of urgency.
They're just not quite in sync. They're just not quite clicking. I don't think they have the cattle, to be honest, as well.
Nice throw, and the crowd will receive that before Hansen does.
Like Ray Turner's got, I think I just said 18 points, but he's had to work hard for him. He's had to do fadeaway jumpers. He hasn't got those points in the paint that he'd really like. Andronicus has been solid, but scoring's going to be the problem for the Braves all season. I think the defence has been all right.
I think Daniels has been super tonight for the Braves. He's got my votes. I tell you, a little hand on it. Still be a centre of excellence ball, but he's done a great job.
They've kept him, they'll keep him to about 80, low 80s. That's reasonable. That's not getting blown away, but they just haven't been able to score themselves. The centre of excellence, their defence has been brilliant, though.
So, keep rolling on. Here's Coonan right behind it. That is the finish of the game,
wow.
I would have thought. Fantastic from Coonan.
When you're 6 foot plenty and you can shoot a three like that, that's talent. That's not his go.
Daniels.
Yeah, this is what I like. They keep pushing Ray out. Keep pushing him out. No easy bucket. Don't let him in the key.
Still a Braves ball.
Because I thought he'd be too strong physically for him, but these boys are standing up to him. Going, so it's a really good scout.
Here's Hansen, need a couple, can't get there. David Hogan looking rather concerned on the sideline and probably not like what he's seen tonight.
No, certainly not from the offensive
end. Here's
Lee,
sorry mate, across, doesn't get there.
But he's got very limited options in what can score. It's basically his two big blokes and Burton.
Here we go back to Hogan in the corner from Dyson Daniels. Very nice work.
You said he's got your vote. He's played a very solid, good team assist basketball. And when he's had to shoot. So a very mature game for a six-foot guy who's just turned 16, although you said he was 15.
I did. So he'll take the foul there, Ray Turner.
But yeah, when you're 16 playing with and against men, that's tough. And the centre of excellence, they've got a couple of 16-year-olds, but they're mainly 17. Just shows what phenomenal talent they are. Australian basketball is extremely strong at the moment. Got more players than ever in the NBA. The NBL was another successful season. NBL 1's got off to a great start. Three throw shooting could probably do some work around the NBL, but NBL 1. But
so Bowen, just the 9 points, make that 10.
Oh, just the 9. Compared to his teammates, yeah.
Teammates have been good as well. 21 for Lee, 23 is a top scorer for the excellence with Dukas, Alex Dukas. And 18 for Ray Turner. Page looks a little blank apart from that. 11 for Burton and 12 for Andronicus, who's been fouled out so far. Bartlett probably got to go for home now, I would have thought. No mucking about with a minute odd on the clock. Hogan, just go for it, they're saying. Bartlett got a few to beat. Hogan loves his three-pointers from there. Doesn't make it this time. And I think the word rust is coming. You don't mind you, they've played one game and had to win the Braves.
Yeah, they just can't get anything going. There's no outside game for them. The points are all on the inside. Burton's been a good inclusion, but on limited minutes, obviously, they've got a program for him. They really need some outside shooting.
Lee, little fakey jobby. Good Rick's been just that, Good Rick. It's not his first name, he's just good. It's his surname, Good Rick. Back on it here. Points, good points for Will Tattersall. Started off slow, Will, and really into the game after that. Coach would be happy with the centre of excellence. 18 is the lead.
And he's got a nice stroke as well. That was nothing but net.
Good Johnston liked it, did the job. So game just starting to peter out here at the Bendigo Stadium.
Yeah, you'll see a lot of bench time for the Braves, not so much the centre of excellence, because they use their bench the whole game. You saw it in the women's, and it's a game in the men's. They've got depth right throughout their list. They've had a few absolute stars today, but they can put anyone on the floor and they know they'll get the job done.
We make their way around the perimeter.
So look at that by Tattersall. He's missed the shot.
It's all a bit easy, and again,
that was hard to guard, because last time down the floor he shot a three ball. Then this time he takes it to the hoop. You don't know what he's going to do.
Last little bit of action, and probably needed that a bit early from Dan Hansen.
Yeah, he's dropped a couple today. He doesn't. I reckon some nights you just got to go, hey, it's not happening for us. Just give him a license. If he hits none from 10, he hits none from 10.
Well, I think David Hogan will learn from this too, that, you know, if you are down by that amount, then it is time to just give him a license to go for it, because you're not going to make the points up in time. That is full time at the Bendigo Stadium. The Centre of Excellence winners tonight, 87-72. We'll run through some stats before we wrap things up here at the stadium.
Yeah, they were very good, the Centre of Excellence. They led from pretty much, well, besides Ray's dunk at the start, they led from go to well. I think the Braves got in front again at one point, but they dominated. So just the leading points, Dukas had 23 for Centre of Excellence, and Lee had 23 as well. He went a bit quiet in the second half. He was very impressive. Goodrick with 14. Ray Turner with 18 points. Andronicus 12. Ray Turner 18 boards. Burton 7 assists from limited minutes. Braves outscored on the bench 21-12. Bendigo dominated the paint 42-16, 26 in the points, but that just showed how good. Centre of Excellence only shot at 37%. I reckon they can do a lot better than that, and yet they still outplayed the Braves. Braves, they go away, lick the wound, they don't have time to think about it, head to Ballarat tomorrow night. Don't think Ballarat be too worried, to be honest.
Things change, though.
I don't know where the points are coming from.
Well, I'm sure they've got time to work that out, something like 24 hours. So.
That's not much time.
No, you're right, it's not. I hope you enjoyed the coverage here tonight, NBL 1. It was the Bendigo Braves going down to the Centre of Excellence, 87-72. Keep watching NBL 1. Lots of great streaming that'll be happening throughout the weekend. Bendigo Braves will be back. Check out the Ballarat Facebook page, because the Ballarat Miners, that is, their Facebook page.
Ballarat Miners and the Ballarat Rush for the women.
So keep an eye on that tomorrow night. More Braves action coming your way. Thanks to City Copy Centre. Also, Pav Plumbing, I'm Brian Coghlan. That is Adam Allerton. Thanks to Johnny upstairs on the camera. Super U live streaming right around Australia and the world. Make sure you check us out on the Super U Facebook page. That'll do us from the Bendigo Stadium, where the Centre of Excellence were winners 87-72 over the Bendigo Braves.
Thank you. and gentlemen.